Thank you for viewing this video today. Behind me, you see a well that was used for years and years and years to bring water for the family, water for washing and cooking. And this well right here is many years old. I want to talk to you about the well and about how Jesus wants to come and sit on your well. He wants to come into your situation today and bring peace and life to your situation. You know, in John chapter 4, there was a woman who went to draw water. Jesus said, I must go through Samaria. I must go. And he sent his disciples on into town to get food, and he comes to a well. And in the middle of the day, this woman comes to draw water from the well. Why did she come in the middle of the day? Most of the women either came early in the morning or they came in the evening when it was cool. But 12 noon was very, very hot. And she came because the other women didn't like her. Because she was known in the town as being a woman who had many, many different men. And so she came, and Jesus spoke to her, and he said, will you give me a drink? Will you get some water for me? And she says, well, you know, you don't have anything to draw with. And I am a Samaritan woman. Why are you talking to me? A Samaritan was half Jew and half something else. And she says, why are you talking to me anyway? And some of you sitting and watching this video today, you're saying, well, why would Jesus even want to talk to me? Why would he want to come into my situation and make it better? Because he loves you. And he loved this woman. And he wanted to bring life and peace and healing to her. He wanted to bring salvation to her. And so he came and he sat on the well. And she said, you know, you don't have anything to draw with. And Jesus answered her in verse 10, if you knew the gift of God and who it is that asked you for a drink, you would ask him and he would give you living water. Living water is what we need from day to day. I need living water. You need living water. Water that is full of the life of God. This is the water. The Word of God is the water. And he goes on to tell her all the different things that she had been into, and that the man that, he said, go get your husband. And she said, you know, I don't have a husband. And he says, you rightly have said, this is in verse 17 and 18, you have rightly said, and even the man that you're living with right now is not your husband. And some of you may be in a situation just like that. But you know, God loves you. And he sent Jesus, his son, into the world to save the world, to seek and save those that were lost. And you can know him as your Savior today. And that living water can begin to flow in you. And a well can spring up in you. You know, it says in John chapter 8 that we have living water flowing out of us. Living water. Verse chapter 8. And it says here that out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water. You know, if we will allow Jesus to come and sit on our well and come into our lives and into our circumstances, then he will bring that life, and he will bring water that we will never have to thirst again. You know, I just think that he is my living water, and I'm thankful for that. And he wants to be your living water right now. And also that water, he wants to just let it flow through you. Heal your body. Heal your mind. Heal your broken heart. Those of you that have been going through conflicts and evil, Jesus wants to come and sit on your well, just like this well behind me. He wants to come and stay there with you and bring His love to you. Receive it today. I call you into action today. Receive the living water that Jesus has for you. And I'm going to end with this today. It's just a little chorus. It's called, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. Be whole today in your spirit, in your soul, in your mind, in your body. Be whole today in the name of Jesus. God bless you.